Hello, welcome to Chemistry Cubicles. In this video, I am going to give you the complete knowledge of Markovnikov's and anti-Markovnikov's rule. Now, before coming on to the topic, I have told you already in the previous videos of haloalkane and haloarenes that how haloalkanes are formed by the reaction of alkenes with hydrogen halo acids. Just like CH2, double bond CH2 plus HX, HX will be any hydrogen halo acid to give CH3, CH2, X. Okay, now this is simple case of electrophilic addition reaction. Now this is the symmetrical alkene. This is our symmetrical alkene. Okay. तो जब भी हम सिमेट्रिकल अल्किन्स की बात करेंगे तो वहां पर नॉर्मल इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक एडिशन रिएक्शन होकर के हमारा हेलो अल्किन बन जाएगा. दिस इज द नॉर्मल केस. नाउ मार्कोनिकोव्स रूल या फिर एंटी मार्कोनिकोव्स रूल कब आएगा? जब हमारे पास जो गिवन अल्किन होगी वो क्या होगी? अनसिमेट्रिकल अल्किन. नाउ कमिंग ऑन टू द रूल, इट स्टेट्स दैट व्हेनेवर वी हैव गिवन एन अनसिमेट्रिकल अल्किन, इट रिएक्ट्स विद हाइड्रोजन हैलाइड, hydrogen halide that is HX, to give an alkyl halide, then the hydrogen, then this hydrogen will add to that carbon atom of an alkene which contains the greater number of hydrogen atom. तो ये जो hydrogen होगा वो उस वाले carbon atom पर add होगा जिस carbon पे hydrogen atoms की संख्या ज्यादा है. Then this hydrogen will move to that carbon atom which contains more number of hydrogen atom. And the halogen, this part, the halogen will goes to that alkene, that carbon atom of the alkene which contains the fewer number of the hydrogen atoms. Now let us take an example. This is our alkene. This is unsymmetrical alkene which reacts with the hydrogen halide to give this product. Now the hydrogen atom will move to that carbon atom which contains the higher number of hydrogen atom. Here we can see that this hydrogen will migrate to this carbon atom because in this and this carbon atom the more number of hydrogen will be at this carbon. So hydrogen will move at this carbon atom and the halogen will move. Halogen will move to that carbon atom which contains the least number of hydrogen substituents. So it will be our major product, and major product often is referred as Markovnikov's product. This major product will be refers to as Markovnikov's product. However, this minor product will also be formed. But its concentration is very low. Now, coming on to the mechanism of Markovnikov's rule, the reaction occurs via the protonation of an alkene. It occurs via the protonation of an alkene. The chemical basis for the Markovnikov's rule is the formation of the more stable or most stable carbocation during the addition product. So here is an example. This is propene. When it reacts with the HBr, remember the rule that hydrogen atom will migrate to that carbon atom which contains the more number of hydrogen atoms. So this hydrogen will migrate to this carbon atom and the carbocation is formed. Here we can see that this carbocation is of 2 degree. This is secondary carbocation and this is called our intermediate, which is stable. Okay, stable. Why stable? Because due to more number of hyperconjugating steps and the inductive effect, two effects are stabilizing our intermediate. And always remember, intermediate should be stable. Now after the formation of this intermediate, the bromide ion or the halide ion will come in contact with this carbocation and forms our major product. However, a minor product will also be formed, but it is of lower concentration. What happened in the case of the minor product? This H will not migrate to this carbon atom or it will go to this carbon atom. What happened then? This CH3, CH2. CH2, then here it comes the positive charge and it is primary carbocation, and we know that the secondary carbocation is more stable than our primary cation, and in this case the intermediate that is formed विच इज 1 डिग्री और प्राइमरी कार्बोकेटायन इज अनस्टेबल और लेस स्टेबल सॉरी लेस स्टेबल देन सेकेंडरी कार्बोकेटायन. सो द मेजर प्रोडक्ट विल बी दिस वन. नाउ दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट द रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन इंक्रीजेस एज यू गो फ्रॉम HF हाइड्रोजन फ्लोराइड टू HCl टू HBr टू HI. रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन बढ़ेगा जैसे जैसे हम मूव करेंगे. अगर हम HF लेते हैं HCl या HBr या HI, सबसे ज्यादा रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन किसका होगा? HI का. ऐसा क्यों? द रीजन फॉर दिस इज दैट एज द हेलोजन एटम्स गेट बिगर द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ हाइड्रोजन हेलोजन बॉन्ड फॉल्स. इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन इजिली सी दैट द साइज ऑफ द हेलोजन एटम्स क्लोरीन क्लोरीन ब्रोमीन एंड आयोडीन. आयोडीन का साइज सबसे बड़ा है. उससे क्या होगा? जो HX बॉन्ड होगा उसकी जो बॉन्ड स्ट्रेंथ होगी वो सबसे कम किसकी होगी? HI बॉन्ड की. Why? Due to this large atomic size of the iodine atom. And when the HX bond is weaker, then it will break easily and the rate of reaction increases. We generally don't take HF molecule in our Markovnikov's rule as its strength or bond strength is very strong. Very strong. So generally we take the HCl, HBr and HI in Markovnikov's rule. Now, coming on to the anti-Markovnikov's rule, it is also known as peroxide effect or Kharaz effect. Kharaz is an organic chemist. He defined the peroxide effect, explaining how an anti-Markovnikov's orientation could be achieved via the free radical mechanism. This is just opposite to the Markovnikov's rule. It states that when an unsymmetrical alkenes react with the hydrogen bromide. Remember, I have taken hydrogen bromide. It is important to know that why I have taken this hydrogen bromide, because any other hydrogen halide just like HF, HCl, HI do not give this anti-Markovnikov's rule. Remember, any other hydrogen halide except HBr do not give anti-Markovnikov's rule. The reason for this, I will tell you later. So, it states that when an unsymmetrical alkenes react with the HBr to give alkyl bromide in the presence of peroxide. So, this is the main difference between the Markovnikov's and anti-Markovnikov's rule. This reaction takes place in the presence of peroxide. Peroxide just like H2O2 hydrogen peroxide or benzoyl peroxide. Then the hydrogen adds to that carbon atom of an alkene that has the least number of hydrogen atoms. तो hydrogen जो hydrogen halide का होगा वो कहाँ जुड़ेगा? जहाँ उस carbon पे जहाँ least number of hydrogen substituents होंगे. और halogen ultimately किस carbon atom पर जाएगा? जिसमें fewer number of hydrogen atom होंगे. So basically this is our benzoyl chloride C6H5 C double bond O O O C double bond O C6H5. This is our benzoyl peroxide. It is used as an acne cleanser. Okay. Now coming on to the example, here we have propene and this HBr which is in the presence of peroxide. Then what will happen according to the anti-Markovnikov's rule? This hydrogen atom will migrate to that carbon atom which contains least number of hydrogen atoms. So, this hydrogen atom will migrate to that carbon atom which contains the least number of hydrogen atom, and the halogen atom will migrate to that carbon atom which has the more number of hydrogen atom. So, this is our major product and also known as anti-Markovnikov's product. Just like Markovnikov's rule, here also a minor product will also be formed. But its concentration is very low. Now, there is a difference in the reaction route taken by HBr in the presence of peroxide and its absence. दोनों में ही difference है जब HBr को हम लोग peroxide की presence में लेंगे या फिर absence में लेंगे. In the absence of peroxide, HBr adds to the double bond by simple electrophilic addition mechanism. Markovnikov's rule लगेगा वहां पर absence में. But in the presence of peroxide, the addition of the HBr is via free radical mechanism. Okay, तो जो एंटी मार्कोनिकोफ रूल होगा वो हमारा फ्री रेडिकल चेन रिएक्शंस की मैकेनिज्म से होगा। नाउ एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दैट दिस रिएक्शन अकर्स थ्रू अ फ्री रेडिकल प्रोसेस, द बेसिक आउटलाइन ऑफ दिस मैकेनिज्म आर परऑक्साइड, जो हम लोग परऑक्साइड लेते हैं, विच इज इसेंशियल एज इट एक्ट एज अ कैटेलिस्ट विच ब्रेक्स द एच बी आर बॉन्ड्स इन टू बी आर एंड एच रेडिकल्स। तो एच बी आर को ये तोड़ करके हाइड्रोजन फ्री रेडिकल प्लस ब्रोमीन फ्री रेडिकल प्रोड्यूस करेगा बाय द होमोलिटिक क्लीवेज। ओके, नाउ परऑक्साइड कंटेन्स अ वीक ऑक्सीजन ऑक्सीजन बॉन्ड, जो परऑक्साइड में जो लिंकेज होती है ऑक्सीजन ऑक्सीजन बॉन्ड की, दिस वन इज वेरी वीक विच इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 35 किलो कैलोरी पर मोल। नाउ इफ स्मॉल हीटिंग लेड्स टू द होमोलिटिक फ्रेगमेंटेशन ऑफ दिस बॉन्ड, देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ फ्रेगमेंटेशन, होमोलिटिक एंड हेट्रोलिटिक। होमोलिटिक मतलब ये बॉन्ड ऐसे टूटे कि दोनों एटम्स के पास एक एक अनपेयर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन आए। ओके, नाउ आफ्टर द होमोलिटिक फ्रेगमेंटेशन द रिजल्टिंग हाईली रिएक्टिव अल्कोक्सी रेडिकल, अल्कोक्सी रेडिकल दैट इज दिस वन, आफ्टर द क्लीवेज ऑफ दिस बॉन्ड कैन देन एब्स्ट्रैक्ट अ हाइड्रोजन फ्रॉम एच बी आर गिविंग अ ब्रोमीन रेडिकल, द ब्रोमीन रेडिकल इज द स्पीसीज। नाउ ब्रोमीन रेडिकल होगा जो हमारे एल्कीन्स के साथ रिएक्शन करेगा। एडिशन टू द अल्कीन विल प्रेफरेबली अकर इन सच अ वे दैट द मोस्ट स्टेबल फ्री रेडिकल इज फॉर्म, जस्ट लाइक मार्कोनिकोफ रूल, जैसे वहां पर स्टेबल कार्बोकेटायन फॉर्म हो रहा था वो मेजर प्रोडक्ट था, वैसे ही यहां पर जो एडिशन होगा अल्कीन पे वो वाले पाथ को प्रेफर करेगा जहां मोस्ट स्टेबल फ्री रेडिकल फॉर्म हो। नाउ इन द लास्ट स्टेप दिस रेडिकल देन रिमूव्स द हाइड्रोजन फ्रॉम एच बी आर लिबरेटिंग अ ब्रोमीन रेडिकल एंड द साइकिल कंटिन्यूज, साइकिल कंटिन्यूज अंटिल ऑल द अल्कीन, ऑल अवर अल्कीन रिड्यूस टू द करस्पॉन्डिंग हेलो अल्केन। नाउ कमिंग ऑन टू द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एंटी मार्कोनिकोफ रूल, एज वी नो दैट इट इज अ फ्री रेडिकल मैकेनिज्म, सो फ्री रेडिकल मैकेनिज्म प्रोसीड्स वाया थ्री स्टेप्स, चेन इनिशिएशन, चेन प्रोपोगेशन एंड चेन टर्मिनेशन। सो कमिंग ऑन टू द फर्स्ट स्टेप दैट इज चेन इनिशिएशन, नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड इन चेन इनिशिएशन, द peroxide compound, there is a homolytic cleavage of this peroxide, okay, such that both this species will get one electron and it will form two molecules of alkoxy radical. Now what happen, this alkoxy radical will abstract a proton from this HBr, okay. Now this will give ROH plus bromine free radical. Now the second step will be chain propagation. Okay. Now what happened in this? Our alkene molecule CH3CH double bond CH2 will react with this bromine radical. Now the addition of this bromine radical will take place in such a way that it forms more stable radical, that is this one. Or remember the anti-Markovnikov's rule that it will halogen will move to that carbon atom which contains more number of hydrogen atom. This will become CH2Br and here comes, this is the homolytic cleavage and here comes the free radical. So it is 2 degree free radical, it is more stable. Why? Because of more number of hyperconjugating step and inductive effect. So now what happens, this radical CH3CH, this is CH2Br, will combine with the another HBr to give CH3 CH2 Br and will produce another Br free radical. Now the last step is chain termination. The last step is chain termination. Now what will happen in chain termination? All the free radicals which are formed are combined together, just like this bromine and this bromine will combine together to form Br2. It will combine all the free radicals together and terminate the chain. So this is the complete mechanism of anti-Markovnikov's rule. Now coming on to the most important question, that why only HBr gives the peroxide effect? That why only HBr gives peroxide effect? Our HF, HCl and HI do not show peroxide effect at all. This is because ये जो हमारे प्रोपोगेशन के दो स्टेप्स होंगे, तो रिएक्शन हमारी तभी सक्सेसफुल होगी जब प्रोपोगेशन के दो स्टेप्स, जो हमारे प्रोपोगेशन में दो स्टेप थे, वो दोनों के ही दोनों एक्सोथर्मिक होने चाहिए. अगर उन दोनों स्टेप्स में एक भी स्टेप एंडोथर्मिक हो गया तो हमारी रिएक्शन या प्रोपोगेशन स्टेप वो रिवर्सिबल हो जाएगा, और रिवर्सिबल होने की वजह से इट वुड ब्रेक द चेन. एंड ऑफ कोर्स द मोर नेगेटिव द एंथैल्पी चेंज, एंथैल्पी चेंज इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय डेल्टा एच. ओके, फॉर अ रिएक्शन द मोर इट विल बी द थर्मोडायनेमिकली फेवरेबल. जितना ज्यादा नेगेटिव में ये वैल्यू आएगी डेल्टा एच की, उतना ज्यादा हमारा जो प्रोडक्ट होगा वो थर्मोडायनेमिकली स्टेबल होगा. ओके, नाउ आई हैव गिवन दिस टेबल फॉर बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. दिस दीज आर द टू स्टेप्स ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन. नाउ हियर आर द हाइड्रोजन हैलाइड्स HF, HCl, HBr एंड HI. वी कैन सी दैट इन दीज बोथ दीज स्टेप्स ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन only both of these steps are exothermic in the case of HBr. Okay, so this one is also exothermic, this one is also exothermic. Exothermic it, when it comes negative it is exothermic, when our delta H is negative it is exothermic, and if delta H is positive then it is endothermic. Okay, so only HBr will have all both of these propagation steps as exothermic. And all others, if one is exothermic, then other is endothermic. If one is exothermic, other is endothermic. And if one is endothermic, then other is exothermic. That's why only HBr will give the anti-Markovnikov's rule or peroxide effect or Kharash effect. And another reason would also be that HI, जो हमारा HI molecule है, उसकी जो bond energy है, वो काफी weak है. That is 297 kilojoule per mole. It requires this much of energy to break the bond between H and I. So the I molecule or I radical will combine easily with the another I radical to produce I2 molecule, and this I radical will not have any chance to react with our alkene molecule. So this is the whole concept of Markovnikov's and anti-Markovnikov's rule. I think this is more than enough, and you will not have any doubt. Hope you like the video. Thank you. Thank you.